Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station where we are going to learn and interact together. We are going to have our biology from 4 lesson 4, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Jared. We are going to handle the topic on genetics and the subtopic, the disorders due to gene mutation. Remember on our previous lessons, we had looked at gene mutation. So now in this lesson, we are going to look at the disorders or the diseases that are caused due to a gene mutation. But before that, we now have the following lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to explain the defects of gene mutation. And for you to be able to be in a position to explain the same, you must be very keen as I am explaining the lesson. So let us follow up the lesson and we shall enjoy together. Thank you. Welcome. The first defect we are going to look at will be albinism. But remember, in human beings, examples of such disorders, that is, include, we have got albinism, sickle cell anemia, we have hemophilia, we also have color blindness, and we have choroidodystrophic dwarfism. But the first defect we are going to look at will be albinism, whereby we are going to say this is a condition where the synthesis of the skin pigment, which is melanin, fails and is characterized by a light skin. It's characterized by a white, light skin, white hair, and pink eyes. As you can see from our diagrammatic presentation, this somebody who is being albino. So we are saying that is being characterized by the light skin, the white hair, and pink eyes. Such individual is described as an albino. Melanin is a derivative of the amino acids phenylalanine and tyrosine, and is synthesized through a series of controlled reactions. Each of these reactions is controlled by a specific gene. In albinism, one of these genes designated by letter A is substituted by a recessive gene designated by a small a, whereby we are going to say the small a, the gene A, the small one, in the homozygous condition, which is AA, blocks in one or two places of the chain reactions involved in synthesis of melanin. This is the result of one of the enzymes, which the enzyme is normally the tyrosinase, failing to be formed in the presence of the recessive gene. Consequently, melanin is not formed and albinism results. The genotype of an albino is homozygous recessive. A carrier for the trait is heterozygous with the genotype that is capital A and a small a, and that's a normal skin pigmentation, like the person who is behind the albino. In a family, an albino can be born if both parents are carriers of the recessive gene. Actually, the probability of a child being born by parents who are both albinism is a quarter, and the probability that probability of their now grandchildren will be half going that way. So that is to mean their third generation, they will automatically produce an albino. The second defect that we are going to look at will be what we call sickle cell anemia. Remember, in the sickle cell anemia, this is another example of gene mutation through substitution in the sickle cell condition. A normal hemophilic type A consists of two polypeptide chains. In the sickle cell condition, one amino acid, which is the glutamic acid, is replaced by another acid, valine, in each of the two polypeptide chains of the hemoglobin molecule. The resulting hemoglobin, known as hemoglobin type S, is defective and has a marked difference from the normal one as a result of this seemingly minor substitution. These differences, we are going to look at the differences later on. Sickle cell anemia is thus the condition where the individual is homozygous of the defective gene that directs the synthesis of hemoglobin S. Most of the individual's red blood cells, as you can see from a diagram, are therefore sickle-shaped, and the person frequently experiences oxygen shortage to the body tissues, hence cannot carry out strenuous physical exercises. The sickle-shaped cells are not able to squeeze through the capillaries. As you can see from our diagram, we have got the capillaries, but because of the abnormal hemoglobin, they are sickle cell, they cannot squeeze through the hemoglobin. Thus, they end up clogging blood vessels, preventing the normal blood flow. This blockage results into severe pains in the joints, arms, legs, and also the stomach. With close medical attention, sickle cell persons lead a relatively normal life. However, most deaths are due to infections from other diseases or damage to tissues. A less serious condition is the sickle cell trait. This is a heterozygous condition where less than half the number of red blood cells are sickle shaped. The rest of these cells are normal and are efficient in oxygen loading. An individual in the sickle cell trait experiences a mild case of anemia but leads a normal life. Such individuals have an adaptive advantage in surviving malaria attacks as compared to those who have normal hemoglobin. Inheritance of sickle cell condition is a case of incomplete dominance. If a man with sickle trait, whereby that you are saying that is a carrier of the sickle cell trait, marries a normal woman, the probability that any of the offspring will carry the sickle cell trait is half. However, in a marriage between two sickle cell carriers, the probability of obtaining a sickle cell child is a quarter, while the probability of getting a child carrying the trait is half. Having explained that, we can have the following activity whereby you are required to identify two defects due to gene mutation. If you are very keen during the lesson, this one you can identify. And for more of this lesson, you can refer to KAB 2017 Secondary Biology Students Book 4, which is the fourth edition. It has been certified by the Kenya Literature Bureau. And also to get this biology lesson and many more, you can contact us by sending us an SMS through the number that is on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV _ Kenya. Let us subscribe to all these channels and you shall enjoy most of all our lessons. Thank you.